DNA testing is all the rage, but is it safe? Today, I'm going to go over what you might actually mean by that question. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. If you're new to genetic genealogy, then chances are you have questions. Well, check out the link in our description below to the five most common questions we are asked about DNA. Some people may not be getting a DNA test because they're questioning whether it's safe or not. So let's go through and talk about what you might mean by safe, because there's lots of different aspects of it that you could be concerned with. First off, is there any kind of medical effects from this? And the answer is no, because you're taking a sample by spitting in a tube or swabbing your cheek. Now, if you go to the doctor to get a specific DNA test for some medical reason, then they may take a blood sample for that. Or if you're in a police crime lab, then they may be taking all sorts of different things, your hair, your skin cells, anything like that, in order to get this DNA profile. But for the commercial DNA test, there's really no medical side effects unless you have a problem with spitting or you have a problem with sticking something in your mouth and rubbing it on your cheek. So that is taking the test itself. What about number two, that information, that DNA that we're sending off to a company and they're processing it and providing some information to us? How safe is that information? Well, that's a different question. It's going to vary company by company, because what we've done is we've taken this spit of ours and we've turned it into a digital bit of information that is stored somewhere on a computer server so that we can be able to access it through the internet. Now, each website is going to have you create a login information and a password for it. They can maybe tell you a little bit about criteria for that password, but in the end, if you set your password as password, it's probably not very secure. That's actually one of the most popular passwords in the world, is password. So in that case, you're the one that affects how safe that information is from just anybody logging into that website. Now, what about somebody hacking into that website? Every company is going to have different protocols in place. As you have probably seen in the news, everything has been hacked. It seems like at some point the IRS was hacked, Social Security was hacked, your bank was hacked. Everything has been hacked in some way. Now the question then becomes, well, what information did they gather from that? Were they able to get, you know, your whole DNA profile? Were they able to get, you know, just that you'd actually had a test? And that again is each individual company. Now, can you say that there is any company that is completely safe from hacking? And the answer is no. No company can say that. Again, you have, you know, different entities all throughout the world that have been hacked, sometimes multiple times. And that's simply because different processes happen, different computer algorithms are developed, and hackers are always looking at ways to get an advantage. Before we continue, if you would like to help support our channel, there are many ways you can do that, and you can find those in the description below, whether it is looking for the free guides, our show notes, becoming an FHF Extra member. The most important thing you can do is to like this video and share it with your friends. We can continue to grow because of viewers like you. So that brings me to my third point with this is, how is this DNA data compared to other data of yours out on the internet as far as value to somebody? I would say, in my personal opinion, is that DNA data by itself is pretty much worthless. I know that you might be thinking, well, wait a second, why am I spending money on something that's worthless? And it's because the power of DNA is in being able to match with other people. Now, there are different ways that you can use that raw data in order to, you know, find out some information about somebody, but those really can be some pretty intensive processes, and it'd be a lot easier to find that information in another way. If I was a hacker, and I'm not a computer hacker, but if I was a computer hacker, I would not be targeting DNA database. In comparison to other data that we have, credit card numbers, bank account numbers, our emails and our passwords, DNA data just is not that valuable by itself. And so I don't think that there are malicious hackers that are targeting DNA databases for the DNA data. They may be targeting them for credit card data or passwords or other data, but not for the DNA data. So in general, I think that DNA testing is very safe. As long as you are putting in a password that is difficult to guess, then you've really done as much as you can to secure your information. Don't let safety dissuade you from taking a DNA test. If you have questions about a specific website, then go and take a look at their fax session or contact their customer service to ask about their data security protocols and how your data is protected by them. Now, if you would like to see why I don't think DNA is that valuable, I have this video here where I actually give out my DNA profile on the video. And if you'd like to learn about something else, then why don't you check out this video down below?